Drivers. On Windows and every other operating system, they're very important. But have you ever wondered what would happen if you just went in and deleted them all? Well, that's what we're gonna find out. Obviously not something you should try at home, but we're gonna have some fun with it. I'm gonna do it while Windows is running, of course. What other fun would that be? And I'm not gonna, of course, use the normal uninstall method. I'm just gonna go and delete the files. And by the end of the video, you'll definitely know why you shouldn't mess around too much in the system directory where the drivers are. So it should be pretty fun. Now, before we continue, I want to thank today's sponsor, Privacy.com, which is an awesome free service that I've personally used almost daily for years. It lets you create virtual unique payment cards you can use to buy things online instead of using your real card everywhere, therefore protecting your banking and identity info. Each virtual card you make is locked to the first merchant you use it on, so even if it does somehow get stolen, the thief can't use the card anywhere else. And you'll also be notified so you can close the card. And you can also pause or close a card at any time, and even there's other features like setting spending limits, and plus, you can also make single-use burner cards. At this point, I use Privacy.com for most of my subscriptions, so I don't have to worry about services that make it hard to cancel. It's the most annoying thing ever. Oh, and there's also even browser extensions and mobile apps, so it's really easy to create and use virtual cards anywhere. Plus, if you sign up now for a limited time, you can get $5 to spend on your first purchase. So yes, it's a free service and you get $5 free credit. Just go to privacy.com/TheoJoe and sign up. You will just need to link a checking account or a debit card so that you can actually, you know, pay for stuff. So again, you can go to privacy.com/TheoJoe or click that same link in the description and check it out. And with that being said, let's continue. All right, so before I go and start deleting all the files and stuff, I want to give you a quick crash course so you know exactly what we will be deleting as we're doing it, so you have a little bit more context on just how much destruction we're causing. Drivers, you can sort of think of them like a translator between hardware and the operating system. So you buy a computer mouse, there's a driver on your system that tells the computer how the mouse is moving based on the signal that the mouse is sending to it. And there are several different directories where driver files are stored that we're going to be messing with. So these are all going to be in the C/Windows system directory, and namely these are system32/drivers, system32/driver store, syswow64/drivers, syswow64/driver store, and the INF folder in Windows. And these folders serve different purposes. So my understanding is that the drivers folders store the actually installed drivers, whereas the driver store folders have driver packages that are not necessarily installed, but may need to be used if a new device gets plugged in, for example. They're kind of ready to go. So what Windows does is if you plug in a new device, first it's going to go to the driver store folder and check for the nearest matching driver for that device and just kind of shoot first, ask questions later, just put in the nearest matching thing just so the device gets working right away. And then after that first quick match is installed, Windows will simultaneously go and try and find a even better driver from Windows Update or something, like a more recent one. And if it does find a better one, actually install that one. And the only difference between SysWOW 64 and System 32 is the System 32 stores 64-bit stuff, while SysWOW 64 stores 32-bit stuff. Yes, I know it's backwards. And finally, let me quickly go over some of these file extensions and file types that we're gonna see, but don't worry if you don't really understand any of this. First of all, there are .sys files, and these are the actual drivers themselves. I believe they're actually technically dynamic link libraries, usually a DLL file, but for some reason these have a .sys extension, but they're the drivers. There's also the .inf files. These are mostly found in the driver store, and these basically include some installation information such as version number, locations of places to install different files, stuff like that. When a driver is installed, the .inf file is also copied to the .inf folder in the Windows directory. And in that folder, you'll also see there are PNF files, which are pre-compiled INF files, basically just the INF files converted into machine code that the computer can more easily read. And then finally, there are some language-related files, such as the INF location files or the .mui, and these are just gonna depend on which language you have installed in the system. Again, you don't have to remember the details of these, you'll just have a little bit better context when you see what we're deleting. So anyway, with all that being said, let's actually get to the fun part. So I'm gonna be running on a Windows 11 virtual machine, so I'm not doing this on my actual computer, obviously, because it's gonna basically destroy it, you'll see. And knowing what all these files and folders are for, I'm gonna try and start with the folders that are least likely to cause destruction, so we don't ruin everything right from the beginning. It'll be a little bit more interesting as it builds up. So what I'll do is start out with the driver stores folder and start out with syswow64 because there's not really much in here at all. It's kind of empty, and it is going to often require me to have permission to delete stuff, so I just have a registry tweak that has a right-click menu menu to take ownership of the file so I can delete it. So deleting that folder was really easy, probably made no difference, there wasn't really anything in it. But now let's move on to the System32 driver store folder. We can start off with the language info directories and this temporary directory. Nothing immediately obviously seems broken after deleting them, so I'm just gonna try and open up some programs like Microsoft Store and just kind of click around, open stuff up. Nothing seems broken yet. Now I can try to delete the file repository, which has all the driver packages to prepare to install it. And it says it's in use, so let's go inside it. And I'm just going to try and highlight everything and delete it. And anything that is in use still, I'm just going to skip. Most folders were deleted, but there are still 36 remaining. And interestingly, it seems like in these remaining folders that weren't deleted, the system files are in use, but the INF files aren't. So what I'll do is just search for the INF files and delete all those, and we can worry about the rest later. Now let's move on to the Windows/INF folder. And I'll just delete the folders first in here. And here's something really weird started to happen. Basically, the computer kind of froze and just kept scrolling and selecting. I couldn't really do anything. There was like a loading circle. So I just kind of let it go to the bottom and then it unfroze. I have no idea if that was related to me deleting stuff or if it was just the virtual machine freezing, but it was kind of weird. So after it unfroze, I'm just gonna try again without using the mouse. I'll just do a shift click. And now it actually deleted all the folders, no problem. And I was also able to just go and delete the rest of the files. Even in the entire INF folder, there was really no resistance. So I guess none of these were actively in use. Now again, we can try running stuff to see if there is any issues yet. So I'll start up the Microsoft Store, you know, click on the start menu, run Virtual Studio Code, some stuff that's pre-installed on here, Edge, Xbox app, and surprisingly, everything still seems fine so far, apparently. But now let's actually move on to the actual drivers folders. These are the drivers that have been installed on the computer, so I'm expecting some kind of response here. Again, starting off with 6WOW64/drivers, no issues deleting this. It doesn't really seem to have caused any obvious issues. Again, this was kind of empty pretty much. Now though, we can move on to the really important one, System32/drivers. The driver data folder is already empty. The etc folder, I'm just gonna delete. I'm not expecting too much from this. This basically just has some networking configuration files and stuff. And then I could delete the language files. And all of these got no problem deleted, except there was only one that I couldn't delete, which was the ntfs.sys.mui. In the one folder, again, that's just a language thing. In the UMDF folder, there was only a couple I couldn't delete because again, they were in use, so we'll come back to that one. And then we come to the WD folder, which I believe stands for Windows Defender, and this one keeps saying needs permission. And even though I tried to take ownership of this one, it seems like I guess there's some extra protections built into this one. Again, we can just come back to this. So now let's just try and go and delete all the individual sys files in here. These are all the actual driver files again. And most of them do seem to have been in use. I wasn't able to delete most of them, but I guess I got a couple of them. But before tackling that, again, we can start to just kind of click around stuff as usual to test things out. And again, nothing really seems to be obviously broken here. Now, as for these files that are in use, I'm gonna try and do a trick to figure out which process is using them by going to the resource monitor. And then I can search for handles for .sys and the drivers folders, which are the ones that are in use. And I can see that it looks like the explorer.exe, the file explorer, is using some of these at least. All right, so what I'll try is just closing the explorer window, see if that does it. I'm not gonna shut down the whole Windows Explorer yet. That would close off the taskbar and stuff. So what I'll do is use the terminal instead of Windows Explorer, and I'll run it as admin. So I'll just go back into the drivers directory and use a command to delete that from CMD. And all right, it actually worked that time. So yeah, I guess Windows Explorer was using those files somehow. So now that we know that worked, let's try and go and delete those other folders that were causing issues. And it seems to work for everything except for that WD Windows Defender folder again, and also one file in the UMDF folder, which is apparently in use by the wudfhost.exe. I looked in the task manager, apparently this is the Windows Driver Foundation process, but I'm gonna hold off on ending that. I have a bad feeling about closing that down. I think it would cause an issue. Let's try deleting the driver store folder again. So what I'll try is use the rd remove directory command instead, and hey, that did work. So let's try and do stuff again, click around, and still not really much change here. I don't see any kind of problems. And even though there's not any actual physical hardware attached to the virtual machine, there are still software drivers for the virtual hardware. I even tried installing some of the bloatware from the start menu. That works. There was no problem with the internet. I look in the control panel, devices, even no issues in there apparently. It's kind of weird. So let's make sure everything is actually gone here. We can delete what we can. We did miss some before. So besides that Windows Defender folder, there is only that one language file in use by that one WDF host. And something tells me ending this is not gonna be good, so I wanted to wait to do this last. And yep, it did not like that. Crashed the virtual machine. It just says disconnected, and then when I try to reconnect, it's just a black blank screen. But actually, apparently it maybe did not crash, because when I went to hit shutdown, actually the shutting down screen came up. So I don't think the whole machine crashed. It was just something weird happened. So I guess we'll just try and restart it. However, I'm pretty sure that this is not gonna work. And of course, yes, the automatic repair thing comes up right away. It says diagnosing your PC. I mean, I wonder what could have gone wrong, possibly. And here, it obviously is not successful in repairing anything. It keeps saying that it couldn't start correctly, so I'll try safe mode. No difference. So this installation is probably dead at this point, though I was surprised it lasted as long as it did and really didn't have any issues until I actually closed that process, which kind of caused a reboot. And then when it tried to reload the operating system, I guess the software wasn't there to do it, and that's what caused the issues to actually start up. I did want to test one more thing though, so I actually loaded a fresh checkpoint back to before we deleted all the stuff, and I basically did a speed run to delete everything again real quick with the command prompt. So at this point, again, everything's back deleted again. I just didn't crash the computer by deleting that process. And what I wanted to do is actually look in the device manager. I figured drivers, probably in the device manager, we're gonna see something, right? And really the only thing I noticed is that when looking at the driver details for different devices, all it says is no driver files required or loaded. So I guess it's having trouble finding info about the drivers, which makes sense. And obviously if you try to update drivers, it says no drivers found. I also noticed that when I try to disable a device like a CD drive and then re-enable it, it is not able to re-enable and it says could not load driver, maybe corrupted or missing. Obviously, it's missing. So basically, it seems to me like what probably happened is on boot up, all the drivers get loaded by the operating system and are just kind of held in memory. So deleting the files don't necessarily cause any immediate effect, unless maybe I did plug in a new device or something and then it was just not able to find the drivers for it. Or maybe if for some reason it had to reload a driver, that would probably be where it would cause an issue during the running of Windows. But otherwise you wouldn't notice anything until you boot it up. Would this have been a different story if I did this on my main computer where there's plenty more hardware installed? Probably, but I still think it might have taken a little bit of time before I would have actually seen a crash if I hadn't rebooted. But still, this should show you that even though things might not immediately go wrong when you're deleting system files and stuff, if you go to restart the computer, that's when things are gonna really end up bad. So don't think that just because you delete a file and nothing happens right away that it's not a problem. Still, I think this was one of the more interesting experiments. Thanks again to privacy.com for sponsoring this video, and be sure to visit privacy.com/TheoJoe for that $5 credit you can spend on your first purchase, limited time only. If you guys want to subscribe, also be sure to click the bell next to the subscribe button to enable all notifications. I only upload about twice a week tops, so you don't want those videos getting lost in the rest of your subscriptions. If you guys want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is another one of these what if experiments where I went and deleted all the user folders and app data folders to see what would happen there. That one's pretty interesting too, so definitely check that out. So let me know what you think down in the comments, or if you have any other suggestions for weird stuff that we could try to destroy on the computer, let me know down there. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.